Hola, soy Kurt y bienvenidos a MedTrack por Medical Tourism y Doctores Especialistas. En esta ocasión, platicaré con pacientes que contactaron a doctores mediante nuestras páginas web. Conoceremos cómo fue su experiencia, así como su proceso de recuperación y cómo mejoró su calidad de vida. Comenzamos.
Good morning. Hey, Adrian. Thanks for joining us and telling us your story.
My pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Can you please introduce yourself for the audience?
Sure. My name is Adrian Smith, and this is my son, Alexander. And I live in Georgia, just south of Atlanta.
That's a nice scenery you got back there.
This is my backyard. I love it. We get deer and all sorts of animals. So, yeah, I love it.
What made you decide to do the whole medical tourism travel route?
Okay. So, it was a 15-year journey. I started very early with reproductive issues in my teens and had various medical surgeries and what have you through college. And they told me after college that my chances of having a child was less than 50% because I had endometriosis and some surgeries. And so as life would have it, I did manage to have children, but life happens. I got divorced and married a new husband. He had no children, and I was much older and still had some of these same issues. And I had gone all over the world. I had gone to Holland. I had gone to Africa. I had gone everywhere looking for treatment because I was living in a state where reproductive treatments were included in all insurances, but the information for IVF ART was very limited. And I was noticing that being a cultural thing as well, the access to information as a ethnic woman was not very forthcoming. So I had to grab and search diligently for information, which made me travel places. I've gone to India, I've gone to Ireland, I've gone to Africa in search of body autonomy and comprehensive IVF care. And it was not a straight line. It was just, where can I get the best treatment at an affordable rate and the best medical care?
And then you landed with Dr. Oscar in Cancun.
Yes, I did a Google search. I was desperate at the beginning of the pandemic in 2020. I was scheduled to go back to India. And the day before travel, they shut the world down. And I wasn't able to travel. So out of stress and desperation, I told my husband, I'm going to find somewhere for us to go. And I started Googling around and came across Dr. Oscar Flores, and I reached out, and within an hour or two, I had a response and the ball started rolling. And that was the beginning of an amazing relationship.
How many time ahead did you plan your medical tourism visit?
To Mexico for Dr. Oscar?
Yes.
I reached out, let's see, the pandemic shut everything down in February. I dare say it was the beginning of March, and by the 15th of July, I had my first consult, and that was everything from arranging accommodations and travel and making sure we were in the healthy parameters and setting the appointment up. It was from the 1st of March until the 15th of July.
And what was your procedure like?
It was amazing. I'm going to tell you honestly, I think he may have been put off by me a little bit because the first couple appointments I had with him, I was very, resistant. I was, I had been disappointed so many times and turned away so many times by different doctors that I was very rigid and difficult on him. I told him from the beginning, the very first appointment, I said, I don't like doctors. I don't trust you. You're going to have to earn my trust. And he was shocked. He was like, oh my. And this is in the middle of a procedure. He was doing a procedure. And I told him this and he was shocked. And by the end of the first week, within 7 days, I went back in for my next appointment. And I told him, I said, you know, I like you. I trust you. And from then, we've had an amazing relationship.
That's awesome. And it's totally understandable after all the time that you've spent looking for the healthcare you were needing and you were frustrated. I mean,
yes. Yes. And I was prepared to be disappointed.
Yes. I'm pretty sure that has changed since then.
It absolutely has changed.
What was your experience when you traveled and you arrived to Cancun?
It was not as overwhelming as I thought it would be. I had been to other places in Mexico, some tourist places, some not tourists, but those experiences were very overwhelming. But arriving in Cancun, it may have been the time frame in which I arrived initially, but it was very easy and very calm and very welcoming. No complications whatsoever. And I've traveled the world my whole life and it was pretty easy. And the people that I encountered outside of the medical professional setting, just in the community, were very wonderful.
And you enjoyed your stay after your procedure? Do you have time to do anything else, or you were just going for the doctors and then going back?
Initially, my husband and I were going to go just for the treatment and the doctors and come back. But once we got there, we said, you know, Cancun, Quintana Roo, and all of the places around have so much history. We decided to go on excursions to cenotes and Chicrets and Tulum and Chichen Itza. We decided to explore a bit. So I didn't just stay in one place, and I am a foodie. So anywhere I can get local, authentic food, Dr. Oscar will tell you, I have probably put on 20 pounds since he met me, because I'm always in Cancun now and I'm always eating.
That's cool. It's a very different climate from what you're staying right now, I'm guessing.
Here in Georgia, it's more humid. It has no trade winds. We have no beach where I am. It's very stifling. It's and culturally, okay, the environment is different. The food is different. The people are different.
And I always think that, for example, when you do medical tourism, another plus side of it, it's you're traveling and, yeah, maybe the first two or first day, you're kind of nervous, hesitant about the whole experience. But once you get cheap changes and you start seeing like, hey, this is a vacation, we can have fun, we can explore, we can do that, I think everything like comes down, and that, I don't know why, I think that helps a lot with any procedure, that the patient is calm and relaxed and enjoying and taking your mind off the procedure and focusing on another thing, food, the environment, the beaches.
Yeah. I would tell people to come, if you're doing medical tourism, especially in Mexico or Cancun, especially, to come a few days to a week before, so that you can acclimate to the environment and get to know your surroundings. Because you're right, if you're somewhere brand new and you're here for this medical thing, you have a sense of anxiety and tension and you just need to relax. And if you don't become comfortable with where you're sleeping and laying your head every night, you won't ever relax.
Yeah, for me, when I had my experience, for me, with a couple of days before, it was awesome. I got to know the environment, go walking, met people, and then for me, I started to feel good. And by the day of my procedure, I was like, hey, bring it. You know, I was like,
yeah, exactly. Yep, that was exactly it. Yep, I was singing, and even in the middle of my procedure, I was singing and talking to everyone, and they were like, wow, she is very comfortable. I had a great time. It was a great experience.
How do you feel the post-surgery, post-procedure, that the doctor handled the whole situation? How do you feel afterwards?
I must say that I've had multiple treatments with Dr. Oscar since my IVF. I've had other medical surgeries done. And when I say I got the best medical experience, I felt really amazing. I felt cared for. I felt protected. I felt as if my health care and my body and my choices were being respected. And I didn't have to compromise anything. Everyone's medical case is different. Everyone's experience will be different, but everything from having the EKG tech come to my hotel, everything from having lab works done at my hotel, having medicines delivered, accommodating my transportation, because sometimes it can be a little tricky to get Ubers or whatnot in Cancun, but even making sure that I had transportation, I felt very taken care of. I'm sorry, baby, you're gonna have to wait. And this is the product of, this is Alex, and this is the product of our trip to Cancun in 2020.
Good.
And now he is just over 2 years old, and wow, he owns the world. He owns the world right now.
He's super tall.
He is very tall.
He's very tall. I thought he was older.
No, he's definitely tall, and mommy is not tall. Daddy's a little taller, so he gets all that from his dad, apparently.
And with that view, because I'm amazed, at the beginning of the conversation when I was saw that, I thought it was like a, how do you call it, like a poster or like a digital window that was like reflecting, because it's so beautiful. And when you said it was like, it's real, I was like, what?
Yeah, that's my backyard. Yeah, that's the backyard. It's a beautiful day out today. I love to spend time in my garden, and Alex loves being out in the garden. So we spend a lot of our time outside until it gets hot. Then we go in for our siesta. We're good.
We're in Texas, so our view is mainly dry mountains.
Oh, my. Yeah, I lived in Texas, Houston suburb, down by Galveston, that area down there, League City, Clear Lake in Houston area. Yeah,
that's a little bit greener. We're all the way in El Paso, and here it's like desert. Get the three digits constantly, and it's dry, and we have mountains.
Yeah, that would be too much for me.
For people like me who like the mountains, it's a very good environment.
I lived in New Mexico for about 5 years, and that was way too dry for me. It was. I couldn't do it again.
Yeah.
I need the ocean. I need water.
So do you have any comments, suggestions that you would like to add to people who are thinking, considering? And by the way, this is not a paid interview or anything. Thank you for volunteering. I think it helps a lot. We have a podcast and we talk to doctors a lot. And one of the things that motivate us to try to contact patients, I don't know if this resonates with you. A lot of people have a condition or an illness, or they're not happy, and instead of going and fix it, they try to live with it. And sometimes they succeed and they spend years with that condition, not being happy, not being healthy, not being whatever the situation may be. And it becomes a way of living. And then they become so accustomed to it, then they get afraid if the opportunity of changing a bad situation comes along. It's like being in a toxic relationship.
Right.
You don't want to leave it.
Right.
And
right.
Sometimes an event occurs outside of their control, and that gives them the impulse to go ahead and change stuff or seek help or go to the doctor or get that procedure done. And other times that doesn't happen, and they stay the same for the rest of their lives, suffering and in pain. And the human body, it was not meant to have pain. It was not meant to be in pain. We're meant to be happy.
Continuously. Right, right.
I mean, we cannot be happy all the time, but yeah, a good part of the time we're supposed to be happy and try to preserve that. And that's why I decided to try to make this special segment, reaching out patients and so they can tell their experience and stuff like that. Not so much as like to promote the doctor, but to help other people say, hey, I can have a baby too. I can go and get my hernia treated or get this done or whatever the issue may be. And I can also achieve happiness. And so I don't know.
And this is amazing that you're reaching out to people for their experiences to make others more comfortable because I've always been adventurous, but I was amazed in my life going through various health concerns where I would run into people, as you said, that had pre-existing health conditions that for one reason or another were intimidated by traveling out of the country. When I first started traveling out of the country to Africa and to India for various treatments, my whole family looked at me as if I had three heads. And my friends would call me and say, be careful. Oh my goodness, something's going to happen to you. And I'm like, no, these doctors are amazing. And I think we get boxed into, and I don't want to offend anyone, but I think as Americans, we get boxed into normalizing being sick. We get boxed into believing that our medical system is the epitome and that no one can do it better or do it equally as well. And no one can do it cost effectively. And that is really what I've experienced through 15, almost 20 years of various medical treatments, from reproductive to my vision to my dental work. That's what I've experienced, is that we are priced out of safe healthcare in the US. And I'm going to be honest with you, some people are in a similar boat like me. I'm not a rich woman, but it costs me more to pay my health insurance and my co-pays and my deductibles here in the US through my insurance than it does to save a bit, prioritize, and travel for my healthcare needs. And I have met people who were just absolutely afraid, and they will. They will stay sick, and one illness will perpetuate another illness, you know, and it won't allow your body to stay healthy. And so I would say to anyone that is even thinking about the idea of going somewhere else for travel and tourism and vacation, you can have a great vacation and great healthcare and come back healthier than you left. You know, and it's not always about having a baby. I've had my eyes done. I've had to have my lenses completely removed. As a matter of fact, when I was down for one treatment with IVF, I ended up saying, oh, I need glasses. Let me get my eyes checked. And that led into a series of amazing examinations. And within 2 weeks, having both of my lenses replaced in my eyes for a fraction of the price that it would have cost me here in the States. So that was amazing. And I would just tell anyone, take a chance. You know, take a chance, because there are amazing doctors, and the experiences you can have traveling culturally, eating great foods, you know, interacting with other cultures is just, it's worth living. It makes life worth living. It really does.
Yeah, my experience was I had a heart condition and I traveled to Monterrey, so I totally understand. I stayed there for 22 days and then came back and it was all fixed. But yeah, I totally understand. For me, my situation, I mean, I don't want to steal your spotlight.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
My situation was, in the city that I was, I just didn't click with any of the doctors. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
That makes sense.
And they were not bad or anything. And
right.
It was good. Right. It was, everything is good. I just didn't click. I didn't felt
right.
I was scared and I didn't click. And then I started looking, and then basically I clicked and I went to Monterrey and got it done.
Right. And that happens. I mean, I had gone to Puerto Vallarta a couple times, and I didn't click with a couple of the doctors and it didn't feel right. And I stayed for a couple, 3 weeks and tried to feel it out and stretch the treatments out. And I was like, it just didn't feel right in my soul. And I just believe wholeheartedly we're all connected and we all have a rhythm. And when we find that person for whatever that need is, you'll find it and you'll know it. And so absolutely, you have to have the right connection, because it's a whole body experience. It's mind, it's body, it's soul, it's spirit. So I completely understand that.
Thank you so much for your time, for sharing with us your experience. I'm pretty sure it's gonna make people think twice and maybe encourage a few to just make a call and try to see if that's right for them.
I hope that I have been a service for what you're trying to promote, because this is absolutely a great platform and absolutely a great option and opportunity for people. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
No, thank you so much. And I hope everything goes well with you. And it was a pleasure talking to you. And it was amazing hearing your story and looking at your view. I had no idea that people had those kind of backyards.
Yeah, we do. They're becoming more and more difficult to get, but we definitely do. And I'm really grateful. Sure.
It's amazing. Waking up to that. I mean, having a coffee, looking at that.
Come visit. Come visit. We'll have a barbecue. Oh, I like to have people
Thank
over.
Thank you so much.
Yep. Come visit. You're welcome.
Antes de escoger a tu doctor, investiga sus años de experiencia, así como el número de procedimientos que ha realizado y si es miembro de las instituciones que regulan y certifican que cuenta con los estudios y conocimientos necesarios para realizar los procedimientos y cirugías que ofrece. En la descripción encontrarás un enlace con más información sobre el tema hablado, así como los especialistas dentro de la República Mexicana que cumplen con los requerimientos para hacerlo. La información mencionada aquí representa un punto de vista y no debe ser tomada como una valoración médica. Y recuerda, invertir en salud para no gastar en enfermedad es una excelente filosofía. Gracias por escuchar y no olvides suscribirte a nuestros canales.